girls here for what? Get baptized? Yeah, that's going to be fun, isn't it? Where's your helpers? Get your helpers out here. Well, look at that. There they are. What day is it?
Mother's Day.
Mother's Day. What day?
Sunday.
May 14th, 2017. Cool. Well, congratulations. This is a big day.
It is a big day.
Yeah. All right. Love ya.
You know, it is also interesting to me, you guys are my first set of twins. Mm-hmm. I've never baptized twins before. And we're starting with the youngest by 3 minutes. So what a wonderful thing. And I want to thank the Davises. You guys have done a great job. And Grandpa, thanks for coming all the way from Minnesota. And for all of you who participate on this day, Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day. So, Claire, I ask you these two questions. Number one, do you repent of your sin? Are you sorry for the things you've done wrong? And do you believe in Jesus as your personal Savior? Then upon that profession of faith, and upon the repentance of your sin, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's be reminded of the fact of our own sin and how valuable our lives are to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. 'Twas battered and scarred, and the auctioneer thought it scarcely worth his while to waste much time on the old violin, but he held it up with a smile. "What am I bidding, good folk?" he cried. "What am I bidding?" cried he. "A dollar, and we'll make it two. $2, and we'll make it three." But no, from the room far back came a gray-haired man and picked up the bow and tightened the loosened strings and played a melody pure and sweet as a caroling angel sings. When the music ceased, the auctioneer, with a voice that was quiet and low, said, "Now what am I bid for the old violin?" as he held it up with the bow. $1,000, and we'll make it two. $2,000, and we'll make it three. $3,000 once, $3,000 twice. "Going and gone," cried he. Well, the people cheered, but some of them cried, "You do not understand what change it's worth." Quick came the reply, the touch of the master's hand. And many a man, with life out of tune and battered and scarred with sin, is auctioned cheap to a thoughtless crowd, much like the old violin. A mess of pottage, a glass of wine, a game, and he travels on. He's going once, he's going twice, he's going and almost gone. But the master comes, and the foolish crowd can never quite understand the worth of a soul and the change that is wrought by the touch of the master's hand. Will you bow with me in prayer? Father God, we do thank you and praise you for your goodness, for the knowledge in all of our lives that we are of infinite worth to you. Father, this morning in our message when we talk about courage, I thank you, Lord, that these two young girls had the courage to walk an aisle, to ask you to come into their heart. And now I pray, Lord, that they would have the courage throughout the balance of their life to live their life in honor for you. Father, I pray that you would give us the courage to live out our faith, to boldly be the people that you have called us to be. Lord, I thank you for the courage of the mothers in this room, and ask, Lord, that you would continue to fill their hearts with our joy. Lord, thank you for the blessing we have to start a service in this way. And we praise you and thank you in all these things in the name of Jesus, our Lord. And all God's people said,
amen. Bouncing evil powers and turning to your grace, protect them from all worldly harm, still call them home. By grace forgiven, by spirit renewed, set apart as a member.